Hey there everybody, Intro here, and today we'll be creating the famous cyberpunk effect on photos by applying hot pinks and bright blues. Hot pinks and bright blues. Well, I created a similar video a couple of days back where I used only the camera raw filter to get the desired effect. But today we'll be making things more simple by using simple adjustment layers. So let's get started. We're in Photoshop and let's load up our photo. Alright, let's start by adding a gradient map, and for that go to new adjustment layer icon and select gradient map. Change the gradient map by adding the left color value of 0000FF. For the right color stop, add value FF00FF. Make sure both of these opacity stops are having opacity set at 100%. Now click OK, change the blending mode to soft light, and this will instantly create a blue-pink color casting on top of our image. Next, create a hue saturation layer by again going to the new layer adjustment icon and select hue saturation. And over here, we'll be playing with the different values of the different color channels, as we'll be applying pinks and blues. So we'll be trying to shift all the color values into the shades of pinks and blues. So let's open our reds channel, and for the hue, let's add a value close to minus 30. For the saturation, let's increase it to about plus 17. And let's increase the lightness to about 5. Next, let's skip yellows and let's go to greens. Over here, let's change the hue to around plus 55. Then let's go to cyans and let's try to boost them up. In the hue, let's enter a value of minus 35. For saturation, let's enter a value of 35. And for lightness, let's enter 30. Then let's go to the blues. And over here for the hues, let's again enter minus 35. For saturation, the value will be 30, and for lightness, this will be minus 25. And finally, let's go to magentas, and we'll enter a value of minus 20 for the hues. In saturation, we'll enter plus 30, and for the lightness, the value will be plus 20. Then we'll create another adjustment layer, and that will be the selective color, and over here we'll again go to different channels and try to boost up the pinks and blues. We'll straight away go to greens and we'll remove any traces of green on the image by boosting the cyans all the way to 100% and taking down the yellows all the way to minus 100%. Then let's go to cyans, and over here we'll again take down the yellow to boost up the cyan, and let's take it down to around minus 30. Then let's go to magentas, and we'll reduce the magenta value to around minus 10 and take down the yellows to around minus 20. With that done, we'll create a vibrance layer by again going to the new layer adjustment icon and selecting vibrance. From here, we'll reduce the vibrance to around minus 20, but we'll compensate the loss by adjusting the saturation to plus 15. Then you can add a curves adjustment layer and adjust the value based on your image. So this is quite dark, so let's boost it up, maybe to something around this. So here you have it. Very quickly, we created this cyberpunk effect by applying simple adjustment layers. But wait, there's something more. You can take any light bokeh and place it on top of your image to add some more drama. Let's do that. I have one light bokeh over here. Let's drag and drop it onto our image. Maybe I'll increase it a bit, maybe something like this. Let's commit the changes and change the blending mode to screen to get rid of any of these black areas, and we can fine tune it by adding a layer mask. Let's take a soft round brush with hardness 0. Let's increase the opacity and let's take color black. As you know, if you paint with black on layer mask, it hides, and if you paint with white on layer mask, it shows. So with black, we'll hide away any traces of imperfection. You can stack up multiple light bokeh if you want to. I have another one. Let's try and add it. Let's increase the size. Let's change the blending mode to screen. Maybe we'll take down the opacity a bit. You can match the color tone by adding a selective color layer. Let's clip it to the bokeh layer, and we'll go to reds and try to give it a pinkish look. Let's tone it down a bit more. That should be fine. But hey wait, there's still more. you can create a snapshot of your entire image. Let's select our top layer and press Ctrl-Alt-Shift-E on the keyboard if you're on Windows, or Command-Options-Shift-E if you're on Mac to create a snapshot of your entire image. Then right click and go to blending options, and inside the blending options from the channels, just remove this green channel. Then click OK, take your move tool from here or press V on the keyboard, and then with the arrow keys, nudge this layer a bit, maybe to the right or left, whatever direction, and you'll have a beautiful chromatic aberration or a digital glitch. I'll zoom in so that you can see a bit better. Alright, now we'll add a layer mask. Again, take a soft round brush with color black and we'll paint away some of this effect away from the center part of our image so that it only stays at the peripheral region. You can add this technique to add more drama to your composition. And before we finish, as there is still something more. This effect works pretty good with portraits and other different kinds of image. Let me show you that. I'll quickly open a portrait image, drag it into Photoshop, and drag this adjustment layers. I'll select one of the layers and hold shift on my keyboard and select the top layer to highlight all of them. Drag and drop it onto this new image, and you can see it instantly applied the effect to my new portrait image, and it also looks pretty good. Obviously, you can adjust the bokeh and align it to your new image. There you go. So I hope you can use this technique to spice up your next photo editing. And if you found this video helpful in any way, please don't forget to subscribe my channel so that it can help me create more videos like this. I'll see you in my next video, and till then, enjoy creating.